Okay, students, today I am going to explain the transactions. Transactions are two types. That means there are two types of transactions. The first one is cash transaction and the second one is credit transaction. First one is cash transaction. All cash transactions are recorded in the cash book only. For example, sold goods for cash rupees 10,000, purchased goods for cash 15,000. These two are examples of the cash transactions. Second one is credit transactions. All credit transactions are recorded in the subsidiary books. For example, sold goods to Yadav 10,000, purchased goods from Mahesh 15,000. These two examples are credit transactions. Cash transactions, so let me explain on the board. For example, sold goods to Yadav for cash 10,000. First we should identify the accounts. Here you can see sold goods means goods account and Yadav account and cash account is there. So here main thing is cash is coming and goods are going, so that cash account is debit and sales account is credit. Then second example, credit transactions. Sold goods to Yadav 10,000 rupees. That means here two accounts are there, one is Yadav and second one is goods. That means Yadav is receiving, so Yadav account is debit and sales account is credit. Okay, so this transaction is recorded in subsidiary books. That means in the subsidiary books, there are so many subsidiary books are there, I will explain later. But one of the subsidiary book is there, that is the sales book. In the sales book, this transaction is going to record. Okay. Next, here one more special point. What is trade discount? It is given by the supplier to the customer. That means customer may be also a trader, to encourage to buy more goods. Okay, for example, here purchases between 1000 to 5000, 5% discount will be offered by the supplier. Second example, purchases between 6000 to 10,000, 10% discount will be offered by the supplier. Here you have to notice that, for example, when we are as a customer, when we get more and more discount, we will attempt to buy more and more goods, so that when goods are sold on credit, purchased on credit, the trade discount will be offered by the supplier to buy more goods. Okay. Next, so second one is cash discount. What is cash discount? It is given by the supplier to the customer or the trader to encourage to make prompt payments. When goods are sold on credit, the amount should be paid as early as possible. Generally, the duration will be 30 days. Okay, so this trader will offer some cash discounts. This cash discounts encourage to make prompt payment. For example, here, cash paid within 30 days, 10% cash discount will be given by the supplier. So when the buyer notice that 10% discount, he will try to make the payment, as early as possible to get the 10% discount. Okay, then cash paid between 30 to 45 days, 2% cash discount will be offered by the supplier. For example, within 30 days, the customer should repay that amount. Okay, but sometimes it may get late, so that he offer only less discount, 2% between 30 to 45 days. So in that period also, customer try to get that 2% discount and he will try to make the payment. I think you understood two main points. One is a transaction. There are two types of transactions. One is a cash transaction and second one is a credit transaction. And second point is, you understood discounts. Discounts are two types. One is the trade discount and second one is the cash discount. Okay. Why I explained this points means, before starting the next topic, subsidiary books, you should understand what is the trade discount and what is the cash discount, and you should identify the cash transactions and the credit transaction. Then only you can do subsidiary books without any confusion. Okay, so next topic I am going to start subsidiary books. There are 8 kinds of subsidiary books. The first one is purchase book, second one is sales book, and third one is purchase returns book, fourth one is sales returns book, fifth one is bills receivable book, sixth one is bills payable book, seventh one is cash book, and eighth one is journal proper. So in the subsidiary books, the first one is purchase book. Let me explain how to prepare purchase book. Before preparing the purchase book, we should know the rules of the purchase book. First one is, credit purchases are recorded in this book. Cash purchases should not be recorded. Third one, assets purchases on cash or on credit should not be recorded. See the format of purchase book on the screen. So there are 5 columns. The first column is date and the second column is particulars. And the third column is invoice number, and the fourth column is LF number, and fifth column is amount. Inward invoice is the document to record the credit purchases in the purchase book, and the inward invoice is the evidence and proof for the credit purchases. Okay, let me explain one example problem to understand purchase book. Okay. Prepare purchase book from the following transactions. 2020 January 1st, purchased goods from Hemant stores 10,000. January 4th, purchased goods from Govardhan stores 5,800. January 6th, purchased goods from RK Bros 3,500. January 8th, purchased goods from Mitra stores 4,200. January 10th, purchased goods from Jain stores. Okay, now I already explained the format here. So we should draw the format. So format is date, particular column, particulars, then inward invoice number, LF number, amount in rupees. Okay, so let me explain the first transaction. So in the date column, we have to write 2020. So month is January 1st. Here, purchase goods from Hemant stores means, in this purchase book, we have to write only name of the trader, name of the customer. So here we should write Hemant stores, and the inward invoice number, nothing will be there, and LF number also nothing will be there. In amount column directly 10,000 we have to write. Next, January 4th, goods purchased from Govardhan stores. So here we have to write only Govardhan stores, and directly in the amount column 5,800, right? Then next, January 6th, purchased goods from RK Bros. So here the amount is 3,500. Then again, January 8th, purchased goods from Mitra stores. So the amount is 4,200. Then January 10th, transaction is Jain Bros. The amount is here 2,500. So after that we have to add all the transactions here. Then you are going to get the balance on January 26,000. So in this way you can prepare the purchase book. And some more problems, if you practice on this purchase book, you will get perfection. Okay, so I think you understood how to prepare the purchase book.